Joe's at home. He'll come here.
About me. They killed my contact. They're right after me.
But what are you going to do?
We're going to have to make a run for the wall.
We? Your only chance is alone. I can hide somewhere.
Darling, you can't hide. Not from them. They're too good.
I would only slow you down.
All right, now you listen to me. I don't go anywhere without you. Without you, there is nothing. Do you understand me? Understand me. All right, we're going to have to move. Let's go.
Any way over the wall?
The way under the wall. Lennon Alley subway station. The bricks and mortar have been prepared by us. All right, now don't talk anymore.
Are you all right, sir?
Mrs. Wainwright was worried. She told me to remind you of your appointment tonight.
I'll be there in 5 minutes. No one is to touch the body. No one.
Captain Mess is coming straight from Washington. He'll be here in a few minutes.
A man was just killed crossing over from the other side. He came through Route 11. Body was found only a couple of hundred yards this side of the wall.
Only three of our agents knew that route. Harris, who's in Buenos Aires. Walton, who's convalescent at the Walter Reed. And Peter.
Peter Murphy.
Mark, are you all right? Michael told me he brought you home unconscious. You're hurt. I ought to know better than to be concerned. Another barroom brawl. I'll order you some black coffee. Perhaps that and a cold shower will sober you up for the meeting tonight. You know, Roger's been calling with you there now. Yes. Would you please send some black coffee to Mr. Wainwright's suite? That is unless you've changed your mind about tonight. Of course not. What a foolish question. Must you be such a pig about everything?
Downstairs in a few minutes. I don't want anyone going through his effects, clothes, anything. You understand?
All right, but why?
Not anyone would. And I'm making you responsible.
Sure, Jack. I know how you feel.
It's Colonel Forbes. I want everything we have on Mark Wainwright. That's right. Mark Forrest Wainwright. No, not the usual magazine, scandal sheet stuff. Where he is right now, this minute. With whom, what he's doing. Top secret, for my eyes only. And I want that 10 minutes ago.
Should be a perfect fit.
How did you find me?
Finding Mark Wainwright is simple.
Jack, give me new cover. I'll get you back behind the wall.
I can't get you anywhere as Peter Murphy. Peter Murphy is dead. Killed in the Hagenstrasse 2 hours ago.
Well, all I need is a new cover.
You have a new cover. You're in Mark Wainwright's suite. You're wearing his clothes. You're even wearing his face.
You'll be out of your mind.
Look, Peter. Mark Wainwright was one of the richest men in the world. He controlled at least a dozen different companies. He could travel anywhere. He knew influential people. It's perfect.
Are you seriously suggesting that I try to take the place
of... How do you think you got here? Somebody brought you here thinking you were Mark Wainwright. Mark Forrest Wainwright, age 36, eyes blue, hair brown. Now, who's to say this isn't your passport?
Plenty of people, Jack. The man had a wife, he had friends, he had family, he had personal habits that I don't know anything about.
I didn't say it would be easy.
Easy? You...
Listen, Peter, as Wainwright, you'd be invaluable to us. As Peter Murphy, you're finished. Unless you want to end up behind a desk somewhere in Omaha for the rest of your life. Here. Put this on.
It's happening too fast. I can't think.
You don't seem to understand the potential here. As Wainwright, you'd have access to high-level secrets involving international commerce, politics. You'd mingle with diplomats, prime ministers. Peter, I'm sorry about the girl.
Jack, that's my business. Don't you ever mention her again.
Mark, you know Roger. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize. I'm Eva Wainwright.
How do you do, Mrs. Wainwright? Colonel Forbes. I'm sorry if I've come at an inconvenient time, but it was important.
Well, we are late, but if you haven't finished...
Oh, we'll just be a moment.
All right, I'll wait for you downstairs in the car. Goodbye, Colonel.
Bye.
Now, wait a minute. Never mind.
Did you expect me to talk to? Mark, I realize it's useless to try and appeal to you on my behalf. But I know that you couldn't care less about me and my family. But have you considered what you're doing to yourself?
I really think that's my business, don't you?
Thank you. talk this over with your sister?
What difference would that make?
My husband doesn't have a sister. Who are you?
Can't you ever do anything on time? Do you realize that you're waiting over an hour?
You've waited for this moment your entire life, Roger. Surely you can contain yourself just a little longer.
Why did you bother to come in, man? There's nothing for you to do here.
There'll be nothing once Mark signs. But until he does, I think there may be a great deal that I can do.
Come on, Mark, let's get it over with.
Everything is quite in order, Mr. Wainwright. It's all very simple. 7 copies, the last page, just signed, were indicated. And throw away the work of 2 generations of both our families.
Don't you ever give up?
No, nor will I ever. Maybe it doesn't matter to Mark that you intend to use that power of attorney to strip my family of everything. And he may not even care that you plan to manipulate the stock and eventually force him out. But I do.
Mark, it's merely a matter of formalizing all the facts as they exist, point by point, just as we agree.
Then why don't you hand it over to my attorneys for their approval?
Because it doesn't concern you.
No, just the rest of my life.
Mark, it simply means that I'm going to go on as I always have. You could have all the money you'll ever need for as long as you live.
For as long as he lives. It would be easier for you, wouldn't it, if Mark were dead? Then everything would automatically be turned over to you without having to go through this nonsense.
We're wasting time, Mark. Come on, sign.
I'm afraid I need more time to think it over.
What?
I'm not ready to sign.
What do you mean you're not ready to sign? I've made arrangements, commitments.
Well, that's your problem, isn't it? Come on in.
What has she got on you, Mark? Whatever it is, we can fix it. Someday, Mark. Someday.
Who are you? Where's Mark?
He's dead.
I don't know who you are or why you're posing as my husband. But the most important thing right now is that Mark Wainwright must not be dead. Will you stay?
What do you mean?
Be my husband.
Take us home, Michael.
Very good, sir.
Publicized Casanova since the invention of the printing press, and bad news in every capital throughout the world.
Yeah, I might be able to handle all that, but will you tell me how I'm going to learn to drink 9 martinis in a row without falling on my face?
These are some of the financial facts and figures. He owns the controlling interest in at least a dozen corporations in seven different countries.
In own.
Until it's established that Wainwright's dead, the present tense applies. Fortunately, you won't have to become a financial expert overnight. He never bothered to. He was too busy with other pleasures.
Yeah, so his wife told me.
But the only time they were ever seen in public together was at social or business functions for appearances. Didn't really fool anyone.
And that is going to be the most complicated part of all, Jack.
I'll be ready for you at 3.
No. Come on, Jack. How many agents do they have?
Enough.
You know, maybe I got taken. Maybe those faces on that piece of very expensive microfilm didn't belong to anybody in particular.
Maybe. Did you get far enough into the Wainwright dossier to figure out why Eva Wainwright is so anxious to help you pose as her husband?
I didn't have to, she told me. I understand her reasons. What about yours?
How about this one?
Yes, that's good. That's a tough, shrewd man.
And this one?
Kruger.
The man who followed you across from the other side. He's one of Vasco's lieutenants.
The man who killed Jarmila.
And you. He's the only one who knows who Peter Murphy is.
What are you doing with Wainwright's body?
Shipping it to the States by military aircraft tomorrow morning to be buried in his hometown.
In my hometown, is it?
There's an announcement about it in the evening papers.
Yeah, just in case our friends in the Eastern Sector have any doubts.
You are certain that Peter Murphy is dead?
And of course.
Of course. You are such a brilliant marksman that your bullets never fail to kill.
I inspected the body. There was ample time to make certain he's dead. I will stake my life on it.
Indeed.
He's dead. He's dead.
You say so. You have another chance to find out how dead. The Americans are flying his body to, they say so, to the United States. Find out if they are, or if they want us to think they are.
I usually eat alone.
How's my speech come?
Finished. I always wrote marked speeches. He could never be bothered. But tomorrow, I'll brief you on who and what you should know before we get there.
Right.
Mark had intended the speech as an epitaph. If it hadn't been for you, tomorrow's occasion would have been the burial of Forced Bolan Enterprises, my family.
But because I wouldn't sign the paper.
Who are you?
No, I can't tell you that. We agree.
Good night.
Look, I know it's tough, but please trust me.
Good night, Mark. Hello. This is Mrs. Wainwright. I'd like to leave a call for 5 in the morning, please. That's right. 5. Thank you.
Good morning.
I hope you take your coffee black.
As a matter of fact, I don't.
Oh. Well, I'm afraid that Mark did, so you'll have to learn to like it that way.
Yeah. And how did he take his eggs?
Scrambled.
And so forth and so on. You know, what we're trying to do is impossible, don't you?
Yes, it may well be. We'll find out soon enough. You know, you're going to have to be Mark Wainwright with a great many people today, some of whom know much more about him than I do.
That should be interesting.
At least that.
Husband, William Wainwright. My father died before my second birthday.
William Hadley Wainwright.
Yeah, Chet Hadley. Second husband, Paul Berry. Father of my half-brother, Roger Berry.
And your mother died when?
2 months ago in New York.
You're a very quick study. Now, we love clothes, so you never wear the same suit 2 days in a row. And he never wore a tie more than once. He tired of everything very quickly.
Everything?
Everything. Am I going too fast for you?
Couldn't possibly go fast enough.
You also throw terrible temper tantrums quickly. It's your way of getting out of unpleasant situations.
All right, when in doubt, throw a tantrum and stutter on D's and T's, right?
Right.
What else did I know about my charming half-brother?
It's dangerous. Very, very dangerous.
How long has he been trying to get control of Mark's... or his company's, his holdings?
His entire life.
Let me get something straight. Mark acquired your family's holdings when he married you, right?
To the merger, not a marriage.
Much of my, donating here tonight.
2 million German marks.
That's $500,000. Very nice of me.
It was one of the conditions of his mother's will that Mark donate that much each year.
Do I know many of these people?
Quite a few. But anyhow, I'll stay close and help you as much as I can. Besides, if you cut anybody, it really won't matter. Mark was famous for his rudeness.
When in doubt, number two, be nice to him. Well, lady, I hope you're ready if this thing doesn't work.
Hello.
habit of being late everywhere. You're aware, of course, that your refusal to sign those papers has put me in a very awkward position. I trust that you have completely recovered your senses.
We've been all through that, Roger.
Yes, and we'll go on being through it until Mark decides to honor his commitment. And he will, whatever you've done to him.
Mark really put up with that nonsense.
And it suited him.
Hello, Peter.
Ask me just to trust you.
I didn't have any choice. It would have killed me.
Why?
I'm sorry. I can't answer that.
Well, in that case, I'm very sorry.
We agreed to trust each other.
You didn't say anything about violence. I count human life much too highly, and I won't be part of that.
Eva. He was an East German agent.
What would he want of you?
We still need each other. If we can trust each other, do you understand me?
Is he dead?
Yes, he's quite dead.
What happened?
Well, perhaps you could tell us.
We were together.
You killed a man tonight, and that I covered for you.
Look, I'm sorry you found out this way. But I am an American agent. The man I killed tonight was on the other side. I meant what I said. You can get out anytime you want to.
I have to keep Mark Wainwright alive until I can stop Roger.
I have to keep Mark Wainwright alive as a cover.
More killing.
Look, lady, I'm a spy. That's my job. It's what I do.
Until when? Until they put a bullet in your head.
Hello. Yes, Jack. All right, couldn't be helped. Now, wait a minute, hold it. This is Colonel Forbes. He's my contact. We met him the other day at the hotel. Now, what do you want to do? You want me to tell him that my cover as Mark Wainwright is over?
No, I'll not stand in your way.
All right, Jack, go ahead. Where and when? All right, we'll maintain cover. Thank you.
Don't. After all, I started all this when I asked you to pose as Mark. The man that was killed tonight might have been you.
Yeah.
Please be careful.
Grüß Gott.
Wie ist Gott?
I'd say one thing in your behalf. You certainly find the most romantic places for us to meet this early in the morning.
That's the only picture we have of him. The only picture in existence, so far as we know.
Wait a minute. Of who?
Took refuge in a monastery 4 years ago when the government tried to arrest him.
Priest, Vraz, enemy of the state, right?
Worked with resistance. He knows places, names, information they'd very much like to have.
I'm sure of that. After 4 years, they're going to go into a monastery and dig him out?
Don't have to. He left sanctuary yesterday. Just walked out, simply as that.
All right.
This letter was found in his room. It's from his sister's doctor. Apparently, the old woman has died.
Oh, so you think he's gone there?
Right.
Where does she live?
Right down there. The village of Kaslari. Only 30 kilometers from the border.
That sounds reasonable. One thing, what's an American millionaire going to be doing in a place like that?
A billionaire.
Yeah, I know there's a billionaire. It's a little new to me. I'm self-conscious.
Kaslavi is one of the best mountain climbing resorts in all of Europe.
Oh, no.
Mark Wainwright was a marvelous mountain.
Beautiful mountain climber. Let me tell you something about Peter Murphy, who gets nosebleeds in an escalator.
You'll manage. And you'd better play Wainwright to the hilt. International drunk, bore, swinger.
In case I find him, I'm the last place they expect to find a priest, right?
Exactly.
And what do I do with him?
Get him across the border. Here's Ford's passport.
Well, that sounds so easy the way you tell me that, James.
Look, Peter, if the secret police get their hands on him, a lot of good friends are going down the mountain with him.
I know. I'll get him.
Think you'd recognize him from this?
Is that the best picture you've got?
The only picture I've got. The only one in existence.
My friend Monsignor Vraz may be a household word in this part of the country, but very few people know what he looks like, which is lucky for him. Security, please get to him. He's a dead bird. He doesn't know what he's doing or how to do it.
So we have to get to him first.
Unless we're too late.
Your paper, please. Thank you.
Take a pick.
Which one's the lowest?
Sprained ankle will be the answer, I said.
Ah, Wainwright. Ah, sure.
Oh, again, Stephen, huh? Good to see you. Good to see you, too.
Thank you.
Shh. Madam.
How are you?
Hello.
You look beautiful today.
Ow! Ow! Oh! 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 Oh.
Wainwright.
Oh, I think it's broken.
Oh, Charlie, you won't be able to climb.
We get you to a hospital.
No, give me a hospital. Give me a doctor. Doctor, what's his name? Hanska. No, never mind. My wife will drive me.
Come down.
Oh. Don't you think my original suggestion would have been safer? Ow. Only bruised. It is. Hmm? Oh, well, if you don't mind, Doctor, I'll keep the sling here. Because I wouldn't want people to think that I just come over here to talk to you.
Huh? What do you wish to talk about?
Well, I thought we might talk about a patient of yours. A woman by the name of Gabler.
Gabler? Anna Gabler? Do you know her?
Well, it's obvious you do, Doctor.
Her brother is Monsignor Vras. He's in sanctuary.
No, not anymore. He left yesterday morning. I'm rather anxious to talk to him.
That's your affair, Mr. Wainwright.
No, that's our affair. I know he's either coming here or he's here already.
How did this come into your possession?
It was found on the sanctuary floor.
It wasn't written by me. It's my paper. My letterhead.
The signature, a splendid imitation. I might have accepted as my own.
Except I never wrote it.
Anna Gabler's health is excellent.
Of course it is. So I suppose the secret police have the village all staked out.
Staked out? My English is not so good. The idiom defeats me.
You understand secret police, don't you, Doctor? Are they here or they already have France?
Why are you angry, Mr. Wainwright? I've told you all I know. The letter is a forgery. I am a bridge doctor. I have no politics. No. They have no charge.
Money has no politics either, Doctor.
Hello?
Alaska.
Good afternoon, Doctor. I'm calling about Anna Gabler.
Yes, what about Anna Gabler? Why are you calling me?
Because you are her doctor.
I'm her doctor, yes, but only when she's sick. There's nothing wrong with Anna Gabler.
Quite sure, Doctor? She's not dying.
No, I give you my word, Anna is fine.
Is it possible to see you, Doctor?
No, I'm sorry, I am much too busy.
Just take the bags upstairs. Use your imagination. Where would you go if you were a bag? Come on, I'll show you where the bags are.
I beg your pardon.
Oh, good. You speak English, yeah?
Good. Just a moment. Your passport.
Who the devil are you?
Police.
Oh, yes, of course you are. Yeah. All right. You're sort of in my way wherever I go, aren't you?
American.
Is that a crime?
Would you mind stepping over here a minute? Can you identify this man?
Yes, of course, certainly. This is Mr. Mark Wainwright. He just arrived at the party only a few minutes ago.
Yep.
And for what purpose?
Well, for skiing, mainly, yes.
In July?
Well, you'd hardly expect me to mountain climb with his arm, would you?
Thank you.
Thank you.
I suggested Monseigneur Vaz change it to something a little more appropriate.
Congratulations to both of you. That's quite a transformation, Monseigneur.
Only on the surface, I'm afraid. If I'm required to act the part, I will most assuredly betray us all. I realize now I come this far on faith alone. I hadn't a plan. There was no cleverness. I traveled the most direct route. Beginner's luck.
Don't knock beginner's luck, Monsignor.
There is no turning back now.
But from now on, you are a Swiss businessman. Your name is Rudolf Agassiz. These papers could just possibly get you over the border. If I could think of a way to get you to the border.
It's only a 40-minute drive. He could take the car.
Unfortunately, I do not know how to drive.
Fortunately, none of that makes any difference because I can't think of a way to get you by those secret police in the lobby.
You don't think luck will get me out of the country, do you, Mr. Wainwright?
Truthfully, no, Monseigneur. I think that's going to take a miracle.
Anton Marulich.
Well, that's right. I guess you are, aren't you?
I wish to apologize to you.
Apologize for what?
For this afternoon. We were kind of rude to you.
As a matter of fact, you were, yes.
We didn't know who you were.
Yeah, I was, all right. That's ancient history, Mr. Marulich. Let me introduce you to some of my friends. This is Helga or Trudy or something like it. And this is my wife, Eva.
You do.
And this is Rudy Agassiz.
Mr. Norris.
Good evening.
Darling, why don't you ask Mr. Marulich to join us?
Why should he join us? I don't have a drink. Mr. Marulich doesn't have it.
I'll tell you, but let's fend for ourselves. Mr. Marulich, come on.
First time since I left the monastery, I was suddenly so very frightened.
Please, don't look so grim. A member of the Wainwright set may be gay or loud or drunk, but never serious and certainly never grim. It's against the rules.
I will do my best.
No, you're not a bad fella, really, Marlowe. You get, but you got a professional cop's face. Now, you just kind of relax the face a little bit. I'll tell you something. Helga here is a much better face relaxer than I am. And you just go on. Yeah, I said good. No, yeah. You go.
You've got to get him away from here tonight.
Well, what's happened?
Well, nothing yet, but I feel there's something.
Now, come on, just cool down here. They've accepted him as a member of our party. Tomorrow morning, he can walk across that border. But not tonight. They'd be suspicious.
Papers are in order. I checked. He's a member of the Wainwright party. Some reason to arrest him.
Tomorrow, he leaves for the West with the Wainwrights.
Must be the priest.
Then give me half an hour with him.
And if we're wrong, if he is Rudy Agassiz, a business friend of the Wainwrights?
So? We made a mistake.
You're a fool, Kopak. Wainwright isn't just a tourist with a camera around his neck. He's a man no government wants to offend.
So we sit back and allow Agassiz to cross when the border opens at dawn?
No, he will be arrested as soon as he crosses the border.
Why should he? He has his papers in order.
He will have a companion. Her papers will not be in order.
Her?
Ottilia. He will be aiding an enemy of the state.
The rules are very simple, Ottilia, and I make them all up.
She can't pull him out of here while the Wainwrights stick this close.
So we need a diversion. Time's running short.
A diversion? Shouldn't be difficult, Colonel. Mrs. Wainwright, she's an attractive woman.
It's time I left for the border. He won't slip through this time.
Mean?
It means that since your husband has fixed himself up, why don't you have a drink with me?
How dare you? Look now, Mark, let's go.
Do you have your papers?
Why?
In the name of Rudy Agassiz, something has happened. They've become suspicious. We've got to get across the border now.
How?
stupid.
Lie still.
I want to breathe.
Let me.
Just get out of here, will you?
She's dying.
Look, you see those soldiers over there? Those are border guards.
She's calling for a priest.
Do you understand something? She was trying to trap you.
That does not alter my responsibility. I cannot deny any person the last sacrament.
Seems the luck didn't last quite long enough. I am a priest. Estam sanctam unctionem. Et suantissimam misericordiam indulgat tibi Dominus.
Requiter visum delequistis.
Amen.
You're going to leave the country, Mr. Wainwright?
Do you have any objections, Milrovich?
Well, Ottilia, are you listening to me? Can you hear me? Ottilia, you see the man. You see the priest. No, Mr. Wainwright. No objections.
Satisfactions in your job? Like Monseigneur Vraz?
Well, occasional, not very many. I couldn't have done it without you. And as a reward, we are going to Vienna.
A holiday? No work?
Well, maybe just a little work.
Lovely evening. wanted you to kiss me. Don't say anything. It's ironic, isn't it? I think I'm falling in love with the kind of man I once thought I'd marry. I understand. Job comes first, right? No place for love in your kind of work, is there? Besides, how could you marry a lady you're really supposed to be married to without breaking your government? Let's forget it, shall we?
It's not that easy. I can't forget it.
You know what we should do? Keep it light and gay. No promises and no commitments. No tomorrow.
In the third race.
You know I never gamble. Security leak, Peter. Bad one.
All right, who?
Apparently Charles Van Zeeland.
Doesn't know anything for me.
Dutchman. Quite wealthy. Retired to all appearances, but actually a control for a couple of dozen of our agents. Less three who were killed in the past few weeks because of that leak. No problem. Your wife is a very close friend of his wife. You visited them a couple of months ago. Bait. Your phony classified armament interest.
All right, I'll need some time for Eve to brief me in.
Sorry. You'll have to wing it. We can't afford to lose any more men. For whatever it's worth, I like number 8 in this race.
So, how would you like to visit your friend, Kate Van Zeeland?
Kate?
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't mind, I suppose. Why?
Do you suppose we could arrange for, say, maybe a weekend there for us?
For us? I don't know. Last time we were there, Mark left the place in quite a shambles. The Van Zeelers don't stand still for boorishness and bad manners. Maybe we could. Why?
All right, well, maybe this time the less you know.
The less I know, the better. I'll ask Katie. She's a good friend. Maybe she'll think of something.
Last time Mark Wainwright was in this house, and I would never again indulge his bad behavior, nor will I. Eva. How perfectly marvelous.
Charles. Mark will be along presently.
That's the secret ingredient of all success.
Charles, it's so good of you to have
me. Mark, let me make one thing perfectly clear. One moment of unpleasantness in my house, one single display of your bad manner.
Charles, I will be a perfect guest. Dietrich, the gate is to you.
How are you, Uncle Mark?
Good.
Your Uncle Mark is an expert at fishing. Maybe I can show you how he does it.
Would you hold my coat for me, Charles?
Yes, of course. Oh.
Oh, the envelope. It's quite important. Will you just put it back in my jacket? Hmm? I'll tell you. I'll take it myself. How would that be? Could you tell me where my room is?
Yes, same room as last time. Dietrich, show your uncle to his room. Yes?
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, Mark. Can you do me a favor? Can you instill some of your enthusiasm for relaxation to Dietrich? He has little talent for fun.
I'll do my best, sir.
Thank you.
You like fishing, Dietrich?
Oh, it's all right, I suppose. Anyway, Mr. Van Zeelen likes to teach me things. And I try my best to be interested.
Mr. Van Zeelen?
Oh, mostly I call him sir. He's not really my father, you know. Are you busy now, Uncle Mark? After you've gone to your room, I mean.
No. Why? What can I do for you?
Could you take me out in the Bentley?
A Bentley? Sure. She's a beauty, isn't she?
Oh, yes.
You can shift her down. She's going to heat up if we keep... That's a boy. You're doing very well, Dietrich. You're going to make a good driver.
Oh, thank you. I've been wanting to learn for a long time.
You should have asked me the last time I was here.
Mark almost had a fit. He didn't like children very much. Dietrich must have been astonished.
No. No, Dietrich didn't turn a hair.
Well, that's strange. I wonder.
Anyway, I don't think your friend Van Zeeland is a problem. But tell me, where was Dietrich brought up before he came to live with Peter and Van Zeeland?
By his father. He's some sort of East German official. Died a couple of years ago.
Why did they let Dietrich come back to Katie?
Because she's his mother.
Or could there be another reason?
This isn't a question, it's a request. Please don't do anything to hurt Cato. Dietrich is...
What is Dietrich?
He's her child. Her only child. And he is her child.
You go ahead, I'll be right down.
May I be excused, sir?
Here's a portrait.
Good night, Uncle Mark.
Good night.
Good night, Aunt Eva.
Good night.
Good night, Mother.
Good night, darling.
You didn't have to dress for me.
Jack, there's been a complication. I think your man, Van Zeeland, is absolutely straight. Apparently, our spy is a 16-year-old boy.
Van Zeeland's son?
Yeah. Stepson, or whatever you call him.
Does he have any idea you suspect him?
Yeah, I'd say he does.
Hmm. Well, 16-year-old or not, you'll proceed normally.
Oh, come on, Jack. That's beautiful in theory.
Is there something in your contract that specifies the age of those you deal with?
I don't have a contract, Jack.
Shall I give you the names of our three men who were killed?
They were grown-up men. They knew what their jobs meant. They knew what their responsibilities
were. That doesn't make them any less dead. Now, you stick close to the boy. Peter, try not to be number four, huh?
game's over, Dietrich. You've lost.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, use your head. You can figure it out. Why do you suppose... They said you should be at the fair tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock without fail.
I don't know.
I think you do know. You just wrote to them. You said you'd been found out. You're no good to them anymore. What do you think they're going to do to you? They're going to kill you, Dietrich. Dietrich, let me help you. I'll go to the fair with you tomorrow. We'll find out who they are. Why are you afraid of them?
I have nothing to say.
Dietrich, it's a lousy world. The smart man doesn't let anybody get close enough to him to hurt him, huh? But sometimes you've got to ask for help. You don't have any choice. Let me help you. Why are you afraid of them?
I'm required to spy on my stepfather and to report on everyone who visits him and otherwise obey all orders.
Or else?
Or else they'll kill my mother.
What do they look like?
I've never seen their faces. They always wear hats or come at night.
Dietrich, I think you're very brave. I'll go with you tomorrow. Do you trust me?
As you said, I have no choice.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm all right, and it's a lousy world, and it's a stinking job.
What's wrong?
It is the boy. It's Dietrich. He's the one.
Oh, no.
I caught it. They've been blackmailing him. They told him that if he didn't work with them, they would kill his mother. The hell of it is, I'm going to smoke them out tomorrow, and I don't have the vaguest idea what they look like. They're going to try to kill him, and I've got to use him as bait.
But you can't.
I don't have any choice.
But he might be killed.
They're going to try to kill him anyway, Eva, unless we get to him first. Eva, what would happen to you and your family right now if it was known that Mark Wainwright was dead?
I think we'd be all right. Besides, that isn't important anymore.
All right, then tomorrow, if I get him off the hook, I'm going to tell Forbes I'm through. I don't like putting a kid's life on the line. Sooner or later, if this continues, I'm going to have to put your life on the line. I loved a girl once, and she's dead because of me. And I don't think I could stand if that happened to you. I love you.
How's it going, Peter?
Not going so good.
How many men have you got?
One. Me.
What are you...
Peter, you have to go it alone.
All right, I'm not going to argue the point with you right now, but I'm going to need some help on this one. I can flush them out, but I can't kill the boy by myself. I don't even know how many there are, Jack.
I'll be close by.
I'm scared.
Don't be not yet. They haven't spotted us so far, but they will.
What pen?
I'll let you know. Come on. Come on. You're supposed to be having a good time.
I'm worried about my mother.
Mother's all right. She's safe at home. I think they've seen us when we got on this ride.
What do we do?
We'll have to separate before they try anything. I'll let you know when. This fear, all of this weight hanging over him for who knows how long.
A part of the weight has been removed.
By luck.
What has not been removed is the threat of his life. I know them. They'll never give up.
Why don't you come to America? Bring him to stay with us.
That's very kind of you.
We'll manage. The three of us will manage.
Goodbye,
Uncle Martin. Goodbye,
Lydia.
Goodbye, Aniva. Goodbye. Mark, I was absolutely wrong about you.
Oh, don't ever bet on it, Charlie. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you.
So we're going back to America.
Uh-huh.
There's a lot of things we haven't talked about yet.
Where should we start?
Could start with being my wife.